What's up, guys? This is Nick at Stridewise.com, and for this extra special video, I recruited the incomparably stylish and dapper Brock at the Modest Man to help put together this ultimate list of the best leather bags for men. On my channel, I've published many, many videos on men's leather bags. Many of the bags are great, some of them are not so great. I'm talking about Kodiak Leather Company, but I've seen enough to land on my list. We're very happy with this list here.
Yeah, and while Nick's channel has focused mostly on leather satchels and messenger bags, I've handled a lot of duffels, weekenders, and laptop bags. Also, I'd say compared to Nick's more kind of rugged style, my style is a little bit minimal, maybe a little bit dressier. So some of the bags that I'll talk about are perfect for the office and for work travel, or just for anybody who likes the smart casual aesthetic.
Yeah, and that's also kind of the difference between our channels, by the way. So if you're interested in more like kind of minimalist, modern sort of wear, Brock's channel is really good for that, and you should definitely subscribe to him as well. Without further ado, my pick for the overall best leather bag for men. The number one is Cravaz FC15. I believe I have found the best leather bag here. I'm completely obsessed with my handcrafted FC15 from this teeny tiny independent company called Cravaz. Why did I land on this bag? Well, for one, I know a lot of guys stress about like if they're gonna get a leather bag, it's gonna look like a purse. And Cravaz did a great job, I think, of making this look like the kind of rugged, masculine bag that like Indiana Jones would wear. You know, it looks awesome with a canvas jacket or a chambray shirt or anything in between. Other cool design cues here include the water-resistant closure here that keeps any water from coming in through the corners here. It's also got these load-bearing body straps. There's a pass-through on the back for attaching to luggage as well. And the fact that nowhere on the bag does metal touch metal, like on buckles or straps. So it's a very quiet bag as well. Now, not only is this full grain leather, but it is Cravaz's own pit tanned, vegetable tanned leather, which a lot of people love because it's a really, really old fashioned way of making leather. It's very natural. It's less harsh on the hide than the much more common chrome tanned and much more inexpensive chrome tanned leather. And this just means that it tends to be hardier and to age better. And because it takes so much longer to make, veg tan is more expensive, but Cravaz bags are extraordinarily inexpensive because they're made in Indonesia, a country that is like the best kept secret in the world of fine leather goods, including boots as well. The customer service is really good. The owner, Yoki, has like flawless English and will answer your questions all day on the company's Instagram DMs. I can talk about this company all day, but we've got to move on to the next entry. But check out my full video review of them here, and also check out the rest of their bags as well, because they've got a couple of dressier options like the CO and some cheaper twill bags as well.
Before moving on to something a little dressier in the next section, I had to talk about another one of my favorite bags, and this is the Mail Bag from Satchel & Page. This is a really cool leather goods company, and if you're the kind of guy who'd rather get your leather from Italy versus Indonesia, this is the company for you. So Satchel & Page's bags are made in Italy. The leather is tanned in Italy as well, and specifically, it's vegetable tan leather. It's sourced from French cow hides and tanned in a small Tuscan tannery with just 14 workers. So a couple of interesting features that differentiate it from Cravaz veg tan leather are that it's shoulder cut leather, and this is known for its consistency. It has a bit of a fuller, more vibrant appearance because the leather has been hot stuffed with oils. It's hot stuff. This bag is unlined and it has a secure laptop sleeve, has a rear pocket, no breakable parts, and while it's pricier than Cravaz at about $500, that's actually a pretty good price for a vegetable tanned leather bag made in Italy. You can also check out the rest of Satchel & Page's collection too if you're looking for like travel bags, briefcases, or even a cool leather jacket.
Next up is the best leather bag for work, like for the office. Stridewise focuses more on like high-end casual wear, more than formal wear. So we looked at more casual bags first, but what if you need something for the office? Well, both Cravaz and Satchel & Page do make office-friendly briefcases, but if you want the best of the best, if you want to impress the kinds of guys who carry Prada, Coach, Louis Vuitton, well, you could pay four, maybe even five figures for bags from those companies, or you can get the same quality from Carl Friedrich.
Yeah, both Nick and I have handled briefcases from Carl Friedrich, and we've both been really impressed. While the company no longer makes this one, this is the Slim Bolton briefcase, they do make something very similar, and that's the Palissy briefcase. And the only difference is the Palissy opens all the way up, so it actually folds flat, and then the leather is smooth, not pebbled like this one. It's a great bag that Nick actually cut open on Rose Amble's channel not too long ago, so you can check out that video too.
The big deal with bags like this, and bags like Prada and Coach, description stuff that we're comparing it to, is that they use vicetta leather. So it's vegetable tan leather like Crevard, and it's Italian vegetable tan leather like Satchel & Paige. But what elevates it even further is that vicetta leather is usually made from calfskin and it's very fatty, making it really buttery soft. It's also typically unfinished, leaving the hide exposed, and it's seriously, seriously premium stuff.
Yeah, another thing I really like about this bag is the hardware. So the zippers here are silver nickel finished from Bergamo, Italy, and every single tooth in the zip has been individually brushed and polished. That means that it zips super smooth, and unlike some bags, like a lot of the ones from Filson, this zipper isn't gonna scratch your computer or your documents or your fingers.
Yeah, I've literally lost flesh on Filson bags like more than once. Yeah, it's also just a really nice minimalist look that works really well in any professional setting. It's far cheaper than comparable bags from luxury brands.
So next up, we'll talk about the best bag for travel. Now, in my video about what to look for in a leather bag, I mentioned three criteria. One is full grain leather, two is great hardware, and three is transparency. And David ticks all these boxes and they actually make my favorite leather bag for traveling. And there's so much that's cool about this duffel bag. First thing is that, as Nick mentioned in his review of the Filson duffel, most duffel bags are just sacks with no special features. But that's not the case with this duffel from David. So it has both a hidden exterior pocket and an interior zippered compartment that's great for keeping your passport, wallets, or keys secure. It's also the perfect size for a carry-on bag, and it attaches to your suitcase handle to help you run through the airport. And that's great because I've always found that duffels can be a little bit uncomfortable to carry with a shoulder strap for a long time in the airport. Also, if you want some extra storage space, this bag actually expands when you unsnap the corners, and it can hold a surprising amount of stuff. Definitely plenty for like a long weekend getaway. And finally, what I love about this bag, the zippers are from a company called Riri. And these zippers are what many would call the Cadillac of zippers, or maybe like the Tesla of zippers these days. But they're definitely a cut above most YKK zippers that you're gonna find on many other leather duffels. So it may seem like a trivial detail to the casual observer, but these zippers are buttery soft, they're ultra durable, and it's a great finishing touch to an overall just great duffel bag.
The last bag that I had to mention today is Bleu de Chauffe, which is a French brand. It's also known as Bruno's Artisans, which is easier to pronounce, so let's just go with that. I want to drop them in here because, first of all, they're everywhere on Instagram. If you check out especially Corey Malky and Marshall Rigmer for some like really cool pictures of these bags in use. And also I wanted to include this because they have really cool colors, like this badass blue on the Eclair Postman bag. I know blue leather might sound weird, but when you've got like a nice gray wool coat or like a brown canvas jacket you want to bust out, this will look a lot better than a brown leather bag will. It's really, really high quality leather as well. It's fully vegetable tanned. The stitching is absolutely immaculate. It's all handmade in France. So the materials and the quality control is really high. Now, there are some complaints with the design though. My buddy Troy, who's been on this channel before, really dislikes this bag because he doesn't like the closure system where there are studs underneath the buckles. The handle isn't very well reinforced either, and it's too small for a 15-inch laptop. But again, the materials and QC are really, really good, and Brock's a big fan of it, right?
Yeah, I'm actually going to steal this bag and take it home. I think it's perfect for a 13-inch laptop, and I actually like the blue because I think it's easier to wear with a brown leather jacket. So that is our list, and we should emphasize that most of these companies offer everything else on this list, so like Crevard also has briefcases, and Carl Friedrich also has duffels, and so on. So I think you should pick the brand that really nails your aesthetic and your price point, and then buy the type of bag that you need from that brand.
Yeah, so thanks a ton to Brock for coming by on the channel. Make absolutely certain you subscribe to his channel as well. It's really, really good stuff. And also, if you're interested in learning our favorite leather backpack for men, we thought we'd throw that into the article below, which also has a couple of our other picks for great leather bags for men. So check that out too.